This is a demonstration on a transistor characteristic experiment. And you can see this is a transistor and its emitter, base and collector. Now let's see the connections of this. And we have two batteries, one is to input side and other one is to output side. Two voltmeters, one is to input side and other one is output side. And one microammeter to the input side and one milliammeter to the output side. I'll do the connection. I'll start with the positive of the battery here from input side, and it is connected to the positive of the micrometer. From the negative of the micrometer, it goes to the base through a resistor, then from the base it is given to the voltmeter. So input side connection is over. Then you start from the output side. Here this is the positive of the battery, a similar connection both to input and output. It goes to positive of the milliammeter. Then from the negative of the milliammeter, it goes to the collector through a resistor. Then here also, from the collector, one connection goes to the voltmeter from the collector. So now the remaining thing, here, this is a common mode connection. Common mode means common emitter mode. Emitter is common to both input side and output side. And now we'll be connecting the emitter. One connection goes to the input side. We need to connect the negative of the voltmeter and the negative of the battery. The emitter. Similarly, the same connection goes to the output side. One connection goes to the negative of the voltmeter, the other one is the negative of the battery. And in the batteries, you need to keep the current off full, both input and output. And keep the voltage zero in the beginning to start with. Now how to do the experiment? To start with, you are doing only the output characteristic. That means you will be keeping the input current 30 microamps. You can see here. You will be keeping the input current as 30 microamps. Okay, around 30. And keep the input current, that is the base current, IB, 30 microamps, and vary the output voltage, VCE, and note down the IC current. And keep this current as 0.05, keep this voltage as 0.05. So I'll be keeping this voltage as 0.05. And note down the current. Next, go to the next voltage as 0.1. Keep the current here, 0.1 volts, and note down the current. Like that, 1.5, 0.2, 0.25, 0.5, 1, 5, and 10 volts. Keep 10 volts. Okay. Next, this is first trial. You can go for the second trial. Now bring the voltages to zero here, and keep this base current 50 microamps, increase to 50 microamps here. Do the same thing once again, keeping the base current it's around 50 microamps. Okay. Now do the same thing once again. Keep this voltage as 0.05 as before. 0.05 and note on the current. This is VC, this is IC, the collector current. And like that, as we did for the first trial, repeat the same thing. 0.5, 0.05, 0.1, 0.5, like that till 10 volts. So that is how I can take the second time. I can see here in the tabular column, these are the readings which are taken. This is for IB, base current 30 microamps, these are the readings. And this is for the second trial for IB2, 50 microamps, these are the readings. Then you need to plot this. Take VC, collector ammeter voltage along x-axis, and collector current along y-axis. Take a suitable scale and plot this. The first graph will come like this. And this is the second graph. You can see the graph. It will be coming like this. And here you need to produce it backwards. It meets y-axis and it is taken as IC1. Similarly, for the second graph, it is IC2. And take these two values and you can do the calculations here for finding the AC current gain of the transistor in CE mode. Beta is equal to IC2 minus IC1 from the graph. IB2, what you have taken here, 50 microamps are converted into amps. Then minus IB1, it is 30 microamps. And use these values here and you will get the value of AC current gain. Once you get this beta value, you can find out AC current gain of the transistor in CB mode. Alpha is equal to beta by beta plus 1. So this is how you can do the calculations and finally write the results as it is given here. So these are the results. The AC current gain of the transistor beta is equal to, and the AC current gain of the transistor in CB mode. Once again, I'll show you the readings. You can note down these readings and do the calculations. See, these readings you note down. This is for the first trial. IB1 is equal to 30 microamps. For the calculation, you need to convert this micro into amps, 10 to the power of minus 6 amps. So these are the values. This is plotted along x-axis and this is plotted along y-axis. And you need to take a suitable scale. You can take 1 centimeter as 0.05 or 1 centimeter as 0.5 or 1 volt. So you can both the graphs you have to plot in the same graph.